What's up, RCHS? I'm Marissa Leon.
And I'm Trey.
And welcome back to this e-learning edition of Lions Live. For our first story today, let's go to Miss Baker with information on Key Club.
Hi, I'm Sue Preifable with the Kiwanis Club of Rush County.
And I'm Miss Baker, and I am the Key Club sponsor, along with Mr. Hadley. And we just wanted to say a quick little shout out. We have now been doing the Wreath and Swag fundraiser for the RCHS Key Club for 26 years. Students this year sold 70 wreaths and 40 swags, which made a lot of money for the RCHS Key Club so that we can continue doing community service projects all over Rush County.
Are you running out of things to do? Here's Mrs. Monk with some book recommendations.
Hi everyone, this is Ms. Monk with some book recommendations. These are not only my recommendations, but I brought someone along to help me choose some books out. This is a graphic novel called The Prince and the Dressmaker. It's about a young girl named Frances who becomes the tailor for a prince, and he actually likes to wear dresses. So she helps him find his own self-identity and confidence as his friend. This is Warhead, based on a true story. It takes place during the Cold War in the US. A young man is diagnosed with brain cancer, and his make-a-wish is to meet Gorbachev, the leader of the Soviet Union, to talk about peace and stop nuclear annihilation, possibly. It is based on a true story, so check it out and see what actually happens.
Thanks for joining us, and come on and check out some good books and learning commons when you get back from Thanksgiving. Hope to see you guys soon.
This Thanksgiving might look a little different. Students are still trying to keep up with their favorite Thanksgiving traditions. Marissa got up with students to ask about their favorite traditions.
Hello everyone, welcome back to today's Lions Live edition, but e-learning style. Now let's get into the video to talk about people's favorite things about Thanksgiving.
My favorite thing about Thanksgiving is probably getting together with the whole fam, but of course this year it's a little different.
My favorite thing about Thanksgiving would have to be my grandma's homemade noodles.
My favorite thing about Thanksgiving was Black Friday, but now it's drinking all the Pepsi in the world.
My favorite part of Thanksgiving is getting to spend time with family and getting to eat a lot of food.
What I find most enjoyable about Thanksgiving is spending time with family that I don't get to see very often, and more importantly, eating the food that they prepare.
Sure, you already know my favorite thing, the food.
Food.
My favorite thing about Thanksgiving is the food.
Having a feast with my family.
Are you watching Tiger King for the 10th time on Netflix? Josie's got you covered. Here's Josie with some Netflix recommendations.
Days on after break. On Monday, it will be Wacky Hair and Slippers Day. On Tuesday, it will be Positive T-Shirt Day. On Wednesday, break out those flannels for Comfortable Plaid Day. On Thursday, dress as someone who works hard and persistent for Persistent People Day. On Friday, show your lion pride by wearing red and black.
One of people's most favorite thing to do over Thanksgiving break is eat. Here's Alan with some ways to shed off all of that Thanksgiving feast.
What's up, RCHS? Here with another quick quarantine reminder. Please, make sure you guys are staying active over break, because I know Thanksgiving's right around the corner, and there's going to be lots of sweets and lots of starchy foods to eat. So just make sure you guys are staying active, and try not to sit around all day during break, and get out, have fun, go take a walk. I know it's cold out, but you can still go in the sweatshirt, sweatpants, and go out for a run. That's it from me. Have a great Thanksgiving, and I'll see you guys after the break.
Hayden polled students about their favorite Thanksgiving foods. Here's more with Hayden.
Hey, RCHS, my name is Hayden Miller, and with Thanksgiving coming up, I decided to ask a few people what their favorite Thanksgiving foods were. First, I asked people whether they preferred ham or turkey. Not surprisingly, though, most people chose ham over turkey. Next, I asked people what their favorite side dishes were. Most people chose noodles, with some people saying mashed potatoes and few people saying stuffing. Finally, I asked people what their favorite pie was. Surprisingly, most people said pumpkin pie, followed by sugar cream and chocolate pie. That's it for me, RCHS, and remember to follow COVID procedures during this Thanksgiving.
When most people think of racing, they think of cars, but have you ever witnessed a gecko race?
Welcome to the first annual leopard gecko race.
Racing the first lane is Mel.
Now in the second lane, we got George.
Now in the third lane here, we have Penelope.
Penelope starting off strong here with a big lead.
George making a comeback here. Looks like he might win the race.
Go!
It looks like Mel and George take the U-turn.
Oh, we have a chance.
It's looking like Penelope's going to win this race.
George pops another U-turn and is taking first place.
Oh, come on, keep going.
Oh, no!
Students, have you always wanted to go to college out of state? CORE investigated on what are some of the most affordable out-of-state schools.
What's up, RCHS? Welcome back to another edition of Lions Live, e-learning edition. Today, I have picked five colleges with the cheapest out-of-state tuition because sometimes it's good to get out of Indiana for a little bit. So I just randomly selected a few colleges from some pretty cool states, and we're going to go through those colleges because they're pretty cool. And like I said, it's a good idea to get out of Indiana for a little bit. So let's get into it. At the top of our list, we have the University of Northern Colorado, which is located in Greeley, Colorado, which is 1,165 miles away from Rushville, Indiana. It's about 16 hours and 30 minute drive. Pretty far, but a very, very, very pretty campus. It has a graduation rate of 48% and an acceptance rate of 91%. And the average cost after financial aid for out-of-state tuition is $22,245. Pretty cheap for out-of-state tuition. That's actually a lot cheaper than some of the colleges in-state tuition for Indiana. The University of Northern Colorado has 12,260 students, so a little bit bigger, but not too much to handle. Very, 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 very pretty college, and it's in Colorado, which with mountains and bears and other stuff. Number four on our list is the University of Hawaii, because why would you not want to say you go to Hawaii? The average cost for out-of-state tuition is $34,218, which is, again, cheaper than a lot of Indiana colleges. It has an 84% acceptance rate with a 58% graduation rate and is located in Honolulu, Hawaii. The University of Hawaii is one of the bigger colleges on this list with about 18,056 students. So it is a bigger college, but I mean, meet more people. It's a very, very, very pretty college and you're in Hawaii. Number three on our list is Salem State University, which is located in Salem, Massachusetts. Yes, the same Salem that the Salem witch trials took place in, which is honestly pretty cool. It's 922 miles away, which is about 13 hours, 45 minute drive from Rush County, Indiana. Out-of-state tuition is $17,994, which is again so cheap for college, especially out-of-state. It has an acceptance rate of 85% with a graduation rate of 51% and offers undergraduate and graduate degrees. Salem State University is the smallest college on this list, though, with only 6,273 students total. Coming in at number two on our list is the University of Wyoming, which is located in Laramie, Wyoming, which is about 1,199 miles away from Rush County. That's probably a 17-hour drive. The University of Wyoming out-of-state tuition is $18,151. Again, super cheap for out-of-state tuition and just out-of-state tuition in general. The acceptance rate is 96% with a graduation rate of 54%. And the University of Wyoming has approximately 9,854 students as of the year of 2019. So a relatively smaller college, but still pretty big. Coming in at number one on our list is my favorite, Northern Michigan University. It's located in Marquette, Michigan, which is in the Upper Peninsula. It's about 611 miles away from Rush County. I'd say a 10-hour drive, depending on which way you go. Out-of-state tuition for Northern Michigan is $6,751. It was also ranked one of the top 10 prettiest campuses in the U.S. It has a 66% acceptance rate with a 44% graduation rate. Northern Michigan's a relatively smaller college, too, with about 8,000 undergraduate and graduate students total. A beautiful, beautiful college with an amazing town, and it's in the UP. You can't beat Peenan. And that concludes our list of some of the colleges with some of the cheapest out-of-state tuition. But if you insist on going to a college in Indiana, some of the cheapest colleges include IUPUI at $9,701, Ball State at $10,020, and Franklin College at $32,990. But like I said, it's always a good idea to get out of Indiana sometimes and just kind of broaden your viewpoint. But that's it for me for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and learned some stuff. So on to whatever's next.
During e-learning, most students are having more time than usual. Some are watching Netflix, some are reading books. One of our students decided to give out a surgery.
Maybe I don't understand it.
Micah interviewed students about their favorite Thanksgiving meals. Here's more with Micah.
Hi, my name is Dylan Rimmons, and my favorite Thanksgiving food would be mac and cheese.
I'm Josie, and my favorite Thanksgiving food is corn casserole.
My name is Annie Hadley, and my favorite Thanksgiving food is mac and cheese.
Hi, my name is Autumn, and my favorite Thanksgiving food is definitely pumpkin pie.
My name is Marlon, and I love the ham.
Unpopular opinion here, but my go-to has to be turkey, and then you get a roll, cut the roll in half, put the turkey in the roll, and then like some mashed potatoes, and then put the other half on top, and you got like a little Thanksgiving sandwich.
Hi, my name is Anderson Frazier. And my favorite Thanksgiving food is chicken and noodles. Bye.
Here is a message from our proud principal, Robert Hadley.
Hi, RCHS students. I hope that you're working hard on your e-learning. I'm here right now with my dog friends. This is Buster, the Yorkie. There's Leo, the Corky, and Lila the Pit Bull Mix. So I just wanted to check in with everybody and wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving and finish strong. Again, keep working hard, get all your assignments done, and I look forward to seeing everybody on Monday, November 30th.
Growing up, were you a Nick or Disney kid? Donna ranked the top 10 Nickelodeon shows. Do you agree with her ratings?
Just remember me when.
Who lives in a pineapple under the sea?
Here is this week's TikTok of the week.
For sports news, the Rushville Lions C team traveled to Martinsville on Monday night for their first game of the season. The Young Lions lost the game 61-43. Trailing 18-3 after first quarter, the team battled the Artisans the rest of the way. Scoring for the Lions were Ethan Kinnett with 11 points, Kane Thompson and Landon Browning with 6 points apiece, and Danny Korn, Chase Wolfe, Connor Parsley, and Trenton Dyer all 5 points apiece. The Lions will be back in action on Wednesday, November 25th, as they host Cheville at 6 p.m.
That's all we have today. You guys have a great day, RCHS.